Hi, this is Kevin with your next holiday gift. This time, it's actually quite cool. One of the fundamental problems with MetaTrader 4, and actually any Forex trading software, is if you want to look on multiple time frames across the same currency pair, you need to either switch time frames off your chart, kind of like I'm doing right now, or you need to open a brand new chart and switch time frames on that one, in which case you're dealing with multiple charts. I figured there was a much better way around this. Also, given the fact that if I want to, say I'm on the hour chart right now, for example, if I want to look at this section right here, but I want to look at it for, say, the 15-minute chart, I would have to open a, I'm on the 15 now. Say I want to look at it on the hour chart. I would have to open an hour chart, kind of line the times up, figure out where it is, and then I would still be dealing with more than one chart. So it's not really all that efficient. So I created something that allows you to select an area on your chart and it'll show you on the same chart what a different time frame looks like. So for example, right now we're on the 15-minute chart. Here's the indicator that that I'm giving you guys. If you look below this video, you'll see download instructions and installation instructions for this particular indicator. So once you follow the instructions below, you can download it, install it, restart your MetaTrader, and you'll see it in the custom indicator section of your navigator window. So we simply double click and it's going to have a couple of options. It's going to come up with this window, and just make sure you click the inputs tab, and then from here you can tell it what you want it to do. My period is basically saying what time frame you would like to see on the chart below. So I'll show you what that looks like here in a second. Box color, you'll see what the box is here in a second. You can actually change this color in case you want to attach more than one of these to the chart. They won't get in the way of one another. And then the rest of these you can actually change after you attach it. So let's go ahead and click OK. And what's going to happen is, zoom in a little bit, you'll see the current time frame is 15-minute time frame. Time frame we're going to be viewing is the hour. So remember, we can actually change that in the indicators variables. And then you'll see this box over here. Let me zoom in a little bit more so you can see. This box right here is basically noting our selection area. So if I were to double click on this box, you'll see it selects it. It actually has the four little boxes on the corners and the one in the middle. You can actually grab this in the bottom left hand corner using your mouse and stretch it to make it bigger. Okay, so let's select the area that we want to view our 1 hour chart on, and you'll notice that whenever we get a tick, whenever the next tick comes in, it's going to update this chart down here on the bottom. All right, so you can actually take this section, you can move it wherever you want, and it's going to show you whenever the next tick comes in, it's going to show you what that chart looks like down here on the bottom. So once again, you can move it left to right by clicking and dragging the middle, or you can use this right here to make it go bigger or smaller. All right, let me go ahead and delete that. Let me move to a higher time frame, and then we're going to put it on, and then on my period, we're going to go M5, which is 5-minute time frame. And you can actually see these numbers up here where you switch time frames normally, M1, M5, M15, M30, H1, H4, D1, W1 and MN. So that one you actually have to have a 1 on the end of it, so MN1. So you just type whatever value you want for whatever time frame into my period and it'll do the rest. So now, once again, we're on the hour chart and we want to view the 5-minute chart in our zoom. So we click OK and it's going to draw our box. You see right here, you just double click it so you can resize it. And on the next tick, whenever the next tick comes in, and this is a real updating chart down here, by the way, whenever the next tick comes in, it's going to show you your selection, but on the 5-minute chart down here on the bottom. See, there it is. So once again, this inside the box is the hour chart, and then this is showing you what the 5-minute chart looks like. So this is really good for looking at multiple time frames without having to use different charts or switch between the time frames. One more really cool thing you can do with it is you just attach another one. You can change the box colors, not to be confused which one belongs to which one. And see, we're on the 5-minute chart on this one. Let's do the 15 on this one, M15. So we click OK, and it's going to draw you another little box over here. And this will show you the 15-minute chart, see? And you can move it wherever you want once again, and it's actually going to show you what the 15-minute chart looks like inside of your selection. So as long as you've got data for it, you can go back as far as you want, forward as far as you want. You can actually put one box inside of the other box. You can do pretty much whatever you want to with it, and it's going to allow you to zoom essentially in to the area that you're selecting. So it's really cool, very, very useful. And once again, this is one of those things that you've done just fine without until now, but whenever you start to use it, you'll realize how useful it actually is and how much it's going to change your trading. So you don't have to switch between charts all the time. You don't have to do all that extra stuff that requires time. You can just apply the indicator to the chart, select what time period you want to see, tell it what time period you're looking at, and it'll automatically update it for you. All right, well, that does it for this holiday gift. Remember, if you guys have any suggestions, anything you want to see coded, anything that you need help with, anything at all, just give me a write. Just reply to the email that you got this from. And while I will definitely read all the emails that come in, I may not have time to answer all of them. We're still, I have a lot of things to do. You know, I'm really busy around the holiday season, so I'm sorry if I can't get back to you specifically. But once again, I always read everybody's emails and always take all suggestions and considerations. Thanks very much for writing in. Thank you for your time, and I really hope that this will make a difference in your trading. And once again, look for some more gifts to come. I have a whole lot of things that I want to give you guys between now and the end of the holiday season, and I really hope it helps out. So until next time, this is Kevin.